I want to introduce my presidential candidate, Jill Stein!
You are amazing! We are the future! And we are that revolution of justice that is happening right now! You got it started, and together we are going to take it all the way until we prevail! We are a movement for people, for planet, and for peace over profit. And you said no to that zombie political party whose days are numbered, but our days have only begun. I want to give a special thanks right now to the Chestnut Brothers for lifting us up 2 feet off the ground where this energy is. I want to give a big thank you, a rousing shout for Bruce Carter and Black Man for Bernie. I want to give a big thank you to Arne Manconi, U.S. Senate candidate for the Green Party, who will help us continue this fight. And I want to give a special big thank you to Gary Frazier, who helped get this going, who's also carrying the fight into the voting booth in Camden, New Jersey, running in the Green Party for City Council. Gary! Woo! Because when a social movement gets together with a political voice, that's when we really challenge power, as we must. As Frederick Douglass said, power concedes nothing without a demand, and we are that demand. We are that demand for economic justice, for racial justice, for workers' justice, for climate justice, for immigrant justice, for indigenous justice, for women's justice, for LGBTQ justice. As Martin Luther King said, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. So we will be a unified movement, an unstoppable movement, because we are for all the forms of justice. We need every form. And when we get together, we say to their little plan, they would like us to be divided and conquered. They would like us to be a movement to stop fracking over there, and a movement to stop police violence over there, and a movement to stop deportations over there. We need to be all of those movements, all together. That's how we are unstoppable. And when they try to pack us up back into the abuses of the past in the form of a political campaign with a candidate who has been the advocate for the big banks, for the prison industrial complex, for the war profiteers, for the fossil fuel giants, you know who I am talking about? Hillary! We say no to that lesser evil, because the lesser evil has actually paved the way to the greater evil. being a blue Congress to being a red Congress in election after election. It was not a set of Republican victories. It was a set of Democratic defeats. Because the base workers would not come out. Immigrants would not come out. Labor, women, justice would not come out to vote for a party and candidates who are throwing us under the bus. In fact, when people say, oh, but you're going to give us Donald Trump, in fact, we already, what gave us Donald Trump? And it's not just Donald Trump. It's the whole lot of those Republican candidates for president, and it's not just in this country. We have a right-wing extremist movement which is rising up all over North America and Europe and beyond because of the policies exemplified, moved forward by the Clintons, by the multinational corporations, by the banks. We must stand up to them all. In fact, it was NAFTA. And it was Wall Street deregulation brought to us by who? Bill. And who was cheerleading all the way? Hillary. Putting another Clinton in the White House is the worst thing we could do for Donald Trump and that movement. We will stand up to them. We are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the solution to the Donald Trumps of the world. I want to shout out in the biggest way possible to the movement to ensure that all Black lives matter. As Martin Luther King said not so long ago, he said, we have a crisis of racism, of imperialism, and extreme materialism. They go hand in hand. We must end, for once and for all, this disaster of racism that is hardwired into our economy and a culture that was founded on the criminal institution of slavery. We must end it once and for all. We call for an end to police violence, but in order to address the racism of policing, we must also end the systemic racism in every area of our society. We call for a truth and reconciliation commission to put this crisis of the legacy of slavery behind us for once and for all. We must share the outrageous stories which have continued from slavery to lynchings to Jim Crow, to segregation, to redlining, to the war on drugs, to the police violence, to incarceration state. This is a continuous line. We must sit down and share the stories of this abuse, and we must also sit down and share the solutions, economic solutions, housing solutions, school solutions. We must end the segregation, the apartheid state that we continue to live in, where the average African-American family has only 5 cents on the dollar of the American family, the average Caucasian family. These outrageous disparities in health, in wealth, in education. This is another form of racist violence. It has real life and death consequences. So we are calling for specific solutions to end it all. End this emergency of racism that we see in police violence. But we must end it throughout society. And as part of that Truth and Reconciliation Commission, we call for reparations for the debt we owe to the African American people and the Native American people for our debt to all of them. And And we lift up their human rights as essential human rights, along with the human rights of our immigrants. Because those who were not brought here as slaves, those who were not brought here, actually who were not here to start with, whose land we stole, all the rest of us are immigrants. Let's be clear about that.
Exactly.
The diversity of our nation is the real exceptionalism of America. American exceptionalism is our diversity, that we are people from all corners of the world who've come together to find our common humanity. That is what exceptionalism, human exceptionalism, is about, that we share with the whole world. I will just end saying that Black Lives Matter and that movement has been leading the way with incredible courage. Like all the other justice movements out here, the movement to make Black Lives Matter has stood up with incredible heroism at incredible danger for you. You are standing up for us all. Because until Black Lives Matter, no lives truly matter in this society and in this world. We call for an America that works for all of us, in which we value Black lives, and we call for a world that works for us, in which we stop the bombing of Black and brown lives around the world. I want to emphasize that right now, our military budget is eating up more than half of our budget, more than half of your income tax dollars. But what it has done is created failed states, mass refugee migrations, and worse terrorist threats.
Yeah.
Let's be clear where the terrorist threat first came from.
Yeah.
This was a great idea hatched by the CIA and the Saudis in Afghanistan in order to stop the Soviet Union. They created the international jihad in the form of the Mujahideen. That was the crisis back then. And that monster has come back to bite us 1,000 times over. It's time for a new foreign policy based on international law, human rights, and diplomacy, period. That provides us all the dollars we need so that we can have the right to a job, a good wage job for every American who needs a job. We call for an emergency jobs program to end the crisis of climate change right now. 100% renewables by 2030. Immediate ban on fracking, on all new fossil fuel infrastructure. We call for health care as a human right for everyone. And we call for a welcoming path to citizenship, an end to police violence, and an end to student debt. Let's bail out the students. We bailed out the crooks on Wall Street who crashed the economy. It's time to bail out the victims of that waste, fraud, and abuse. And to make public higher education free. I'm just gonna conclude saying, you are the future. You got